Of NCAA basketball is brought to you by the Wide Track Grand Prix by Pontiac. Wider is better.
Let's check the starting lineups for Gary Williams and Marilyn Stokes and Francis. The backcourt, Morris Prophet up front, and Lonnie Baxter is the guy that has had to take over now with Abino Kizzi out for the season with the Achilles injury. For Georgia Tech, Akins, Collier, Babel, Floyd, and Alvin Jones. And Jason Floyd, a guy that plays so well at home and, quite frankly, doesn't play very well on the road. They're going to need his scoring today in this one. Bobby Cremins, in his 18th year, 340 wins, fourth all-time in the ACC. And against Maryland, the best they've done against any ACC team. And Gary Williams, 10th year, and looking to become the second most victories in a single season. Back in the 94-95 campaign, they won 26. Right now, they have 22. And, Jay, a number one seed, really, in the NCAA tournament is not without possibility now for Maryland if they should maybe put a run together and run the table.
Yeah, they'd have to run the table and probably win the ACC tournament championship, but I agree with you, especially with UConn losing. That number one seed's still up for grabs.
Alvin Jones, that hook shot slipped off his hand a little bit, but he got it back. And Floyd brings it right back to him.
Maryland starts in man-to-man.
They're working Jones inside. Block shot by Baxter. Jones got it back. Reverse layup.
Georgia Tech trying to go inside early to test Lonnie Baxter. Perhaps get some fouls on the freshman.
Jason Floyd kicks it out of bounds. For Georgia Tech, the early lead.
One of the ways that Obinna Kizzi will be missed is defensively inside. He knows all the tricks, knows how to stay away from foul trouble. Oftentimes, freshmen do not know that.
Consensus, it seems, of the Maryland coaches, and I know you talked to Gary, I talked to Billy Hine before the game, as Baxter takes it inside to tie it at two, is that they did well those two games, kind of working on adrenaline and playing against North Carolina and everything, but can Baxter hold up and be the guy with a Kizzi out? You know, sometimes it's over the long haul that you find out whether or not you can get by without a big fella.
That's exactly right, when you've got to do it game after game. Great steal.
Stokes ahead to Francis on the fly.
I mean, he just exploded past Jason Collier. That little 1-2-1-1 press, so effective. Well, you better be strong with the ball against Maryland. They take some slaps at it. They're great in rear pursuit. Once you get past them, they come from behind you to knock it away.
Babel gave up an open jumper on the baseline. Stokes playing so well. You know, you and I were talking about how he played against Coda in North Carolina. Collier got up in the air, and jump ball is going to give it back to Maryland. But the key for Georgia Tech today, Bobby Cremins mentioned it with you right before our tip, is Tony Akins has to be able to handle the basketball, and he's already got one turnover.
Well, turnovers were the real problem the last time these two teams played. Jason Collier turned it over 8 times by himself, and there were 27 turnovers overall for Georgia Tech. That's too many.
Looking at the stats of that game, it was remarkable how many Georgia Tech players had anywhere from 5 to 8 turnovers in that game. And Maryland, after spotting Tech the first basket of the ball game, has now run off 6 straight.
Nice job there in the half court. And Alvin Jones limping a little bit. Jim Burr blowing his whistle to see if the big guy is okay. Alvin Jones been on a little bit of a tear lately. He was brilliant against both Florida State and Louisville. Tailed off a little bit again, the loss to Wake Forest.
Try to trap Akins in the backcourt. And now Collier will bring it in to the front court and threw it away. Boy, there's going to be enough times when Tech will turn it over without just throwing it away with an unforced pass like that.
Well, Maryland's sticking with their game plan. They want to get the ball out of the hands of Tony Akins, force other players to handle it who are not used to handling the ball, and that's going to spell some turnovers if they're not careful.
Francis, no-look pass in the paint.
Good poise by Terrence Morris. Didn't have it, just kicked it back out against this 2-3 zone.
Francis working the baseline, bumps into Jones, got a pass inside to Morris, and his second chance is good.
Terrence Morris is just so smooth as a basketball player. Great along the baseline, an outstanding finisher. Got up for that second shot and stick back so quickly that nobody was able to recover for Georgia Tech.
Bobby Cremins trying to nip the Maryland 8-point run in the bud and calls a 20-second timeout. 8-2. Georgia Tech, Alvin Jones got the first basket. 8 straight points for Maryland.
but you really worry when you, especially when you have a young team, young guards, when you're playing against a team that can press you and put some points on the board in a hurry. You want to get off to a good start. And here are the big guns for Maryland. Terrence Morris leading the team in scoring. The junior college transfer, the sensational Steve Francis just behind him. And LaRon Proffitt has been very consistent all season long, shooting 50% on the year. That's his best career.
Jones got three underneath. Missed in close, but it'll go to the free throw line.
That, Brad, is the way you break pressure. Once you break that initial line of pressure, you are going to have an advantage going down the other end. If you break the press to score, you can get some opportunities. But if you just break it to get it across half court, then you're really defeating the purpose. You're going to have to go against that half court defense.
Those numbers on Elvin Jones that you saw with and without Collier, if you think it's because of injury, remember Jason Collier didn't play until December this year after sitting out the remainder of his transfer from last season from Indiana. So it's Elvin Jones with all of Tech's points. 8-4 Maryland.
Georgia Tech going man-to-man on this possession.
Floyd on profit. High post and a 15-footer. Oh, Morris drills it.
Isn't that pretty? Set the little screen along the baseline. So worried about opening up that baseline, nobody paid attention to Morris, and he's got such a sweet touch.
He and Francis off to a tremendous start. Well, Collier walked with it.
And see, that's how those turnovers pile up. That's his second turnover. Remember, he had eight in Cole Fieldhouse the last time these two teams played. And they want to force Jason Collier to put the ball on the floor. When he can catch it and shoot it, he's really dangerous. Not as effective when he's got to put it down and make a play.
You mentioned the eight turnovers that Collier had. Babel had six. Akins had six. And yeah, that's the Colliers. And it was an awful performance in handling the basketball at the Cole Fieldhouse.
And they stayed close up until the last seven or eight minutes when Maryland went on, I think it was a 21-5 run and put it away.
Here's Baxter muscling his way inside. Alvin Jones leads the ACC in rebounds, and he clears that one off.
It might not be quick when Lonnie Baxter takes the basket, but it's hard.
Babel had it blocked by Morris. He went up strong, but Morris kissed it off the glass, and it's Francis on a runner.
Well, he is just so fun to watch.
He really is.
If you don't stop the ball, he'll take it right over you, and that's exactly what he did to Tony Akins.
8-point Maryland lead. Jones has been the one constant for Tech, but he missed in close again. Floyd, second chance, got it.
Well, the one place you worry without Obinna Kizzy in there is trying to clean up the defensive board. Terrence Morris has done a much better job rebounding. He's concentrated on it a lot more since Obinna Kizzy's been out, but Baxter's got to do it as well.
Proffitt hangs in the air. Jones another board. Trying to find the handle. Almost double dribbled with it. Georgia Tech with an opportunity to cut it to four. Akins trying to kick it outside. He's got another turnover. Steal by LaRon Proffitt. Proffitt leaves it for Morris. And follows Morris miss. Morris got two chances at it, though.
Boy, how about the stop-and-go move by Terrence Morris? Catching that ball on the run, letting the defense run past, and then putting it up. And great hands by LaRon Proffitt going in to stop the penetration and then stopping the pass out to Floyd.
Almost threw it away again. Floyd packs it in low to Jones. He's bumped from behind. Foul before the shot. As he got hip-checked down low. Foul's going to be on Terrell Stokes, who undercut him, and we'll have to have Georgia Tech with the ball when we return. Right now, Maryland flying high and leading 14-6.
With its wider track and precise cornering, nothing can contain the White Track Grand Prix, not even your television. Stand by as we adjust your screen. Now you can catch the White Track Grand Prix GT and experience its outstanding cornering and control. Drive it for yourself and see why wider is better. The White Track Grand Prix by Pontiac. Now you can lease the Grand Prix GT sedan for just $269 a month. See your Pontiac dealer today.
Feeling burnt out? Tired of the daily grind? 1-800-COLLECT and the new movie Office Space can help. Make your next call with 1-800-COLLECT, the cheap way to call collect, and you could win a year's pay. Now, every completed 1-800-COLLECT call enters you for a chance to win $50,000,
Greg,
to do whatever you want.
I would do nothing.
The more 1-800-COLLECT calls you make, the more chances you have to win. Call 1-800-COLLECT today and check out the new movie Office Space.
The Soft Drink Syndicate knows there's still some people who resist them.
2 pounds in Sector 3, sir.
And they don't like this at all. The 7-Up Underground are people who drink what they like, not what they're supposed to like.
What's with the suits?
And what they like is the crisp, refreshing taste of 7-Up.
Stop those hands!
You must pay for Mr. Squeaky.
Do you do what you like? Are you an un?
Let's take you back, flashback to 4 years ago. Matt Harpering, then a freshman at Georgia Tech. Put on quite a show, 28 points. Travis Best was Georgia Tech's point guard at the time. He knocked down 30. And a then number 5 Maryland team upset by Georgia Tech here at Alexander Memorial Coliseum, 100-91. So far, Maryland off to a great start here today. They've got an 8-point lead with 15:06 to go in the first half. Brad Nessler and Jay Billis with you. Alvin Jones, 4 points and 4 rebounds so far in the ball game. He's been pretty much Tech's offense.
And Maryland has just shown their explosivity going the other way, able to get some easy baskets, not having to go against Georgia Tech's half-court defense as much.
Collier, Akins, Jones, Floyd, and Babel. Georgia Tech stays with its starting five. Collier, left-hand hook, good-looking move, just didn't drop four. Martisich clears it off to Francis. He's thinking about taking it himself, and in the paint, had it stripped out of there. And a foul is going to be on Tony Akins.
Pretty good outlet pass by Mike Martisich to get that break started. Martisich is another guy, in addition to Lonnie Baxter, that can really step forward now with the Kesey out and be a factor for this team.
Stokes lobs it into Morris.
How good has Terrell Stokes been all year long?
Running consistent, huh?
Running the team, and he did something I thought was impossible against Ed Cody. Kept the ball. He kept Cota in front of him the whole game. Did just a superior defensive job holding him just 5 points.
Collier can shoot out there. Got it.
See, that's why you want to make Jason Collier put the ball on the floor. When he just catches it and shoots it, he is dead on.
That came off Maryland's first turnover. And Steve Francis, it's Maryland's second turnover. Last two trips, they've given it back and given Georgia Tech new life, trailing by 5. The Yellow Jackets with a chance to cut into that lead.
Here's a 2-1-2 three-quarter court press put on by Maryland. They can really turn you over in this thing if you're not careful.
Babel goes right by everybody and dishes to Jones, who slams it.
What a great play by John Babel. Catch, face, read the defense. That was textbook.
Tech was in a danger zone a moment ago, and now they're only down 3. Babel going for the steal, picks up the foul.
That's an energizing play for Georgia Tech. John Babel caught the basketball immediately without dribbling. He turned and faced the defense and saw the opening and drew the defense to him on the drive to leave it off for Alvin Jones. That's the way you break pressure.
6 minutes into the game, Maryland by 3. Badly missed three-pointer. Alvin Jones, nice outlet for Jason Floyd, who waits for numbers. And now T.J. Vines, who just checked in, misses a 3. That could have tied it up. Aron Proffitt coming the other way. Francis backpedals and fires. Martisich over Collier, but Collier got the better of it. Tech again a chance to make it a 1-point game.
Nice pass.
Knocked away from behind by Morris. So the outlet to Francis. Let's see, will he beat Babel in the hole? Yes. And a chance for a 3-point play, and Babel's got 2 quick fouls.
And the crowd wants a little over-the-top call to knock away that pass. Babel doing a nice job of looking inside on the high-low. And it does look like Terrence Morris went over the top. He just fed him on the wrong side. It was a terrific idea. You got to go more to the left side there. And Steve Francis just shoots right past Babel. Gets the inside track, uses the basket very effectively to draw that foul.
So Steve Francis going to the free throw line. Duke Edsel checking his elbow, I think, to see whether or not there was any blood. A little blood in Steve's mouth earlier this week. Had his 2 bottom wisdom teeth removed on Monday, and I asked him before the game how he's doing. He said, Mr. Nessler, still got a headache. He's still on antibiotics, and gets the ball back off the miss. And Laron Proffitt makes that a 4-point trip for Maryland.
When you allow Laron Proffitt to get his feet set on a jump shot, he can knock it down.
Lead back to 7.
Now, Steve Francis can not only play offensively, but he's a very good defender as well.
Yes,
really quick
is.
Hands.
Floyd for three. E.J. Vines in the right place at the right time for the rebound. Kyer up in the air, kicks it to Akins. He's been struggling with his outside shooting. And does there as well. Profit will clear it off.
Well, he missed it, but a good shot. Nice shot fake, putting the ball on the floor.
Francis now will bring it out. He's playing the point.
He'll get them into a set. There's the high screen by Martišić.
Nice dish underneath. Baxter blocked by Jones. And now Kyer fighting with Francis for control. And a foul on Maryland.
Collier doing a great job of being strong. But look at that block by Jones. And then Collier going down on the floor. You like to see a guy dive for that ball, but he was able to bend over at the waist and pick it up. And that's the kind of impact that Alvin Jones can have on a basketball game. Not only does he block a lot of shots, he changes a lot as well. I think he caused that travel earlier in the game by Steve Francis when he turned around in the lane and saw Jones standing there. You've got to know where he is all the time.
That block by Alvin Jones ties the school record set by John Sally. The next one, it'll be all by himself. Kyle, you're outside. Got it. A three-pointer. Huge shot for Tech.
And Brian Watkins not out there to guard him. He's not used to guarding big guys out at the three-point line, so he gives him a little bit extra room, and that's where Collier can just drill you.
Martišić down to Profit, who's got a big height advantage on Akins. But Jones, another rebound. He's been a force in the middle. And Georgia Tech can cut it to two again this trip if they score.
That's still a good look inside. Profit loves to do that, cut through and then come back and post a smaller guy.
Collier's feeling it outside right now. This time he takes it inside. Pretty good dish, but Jones was a little too far in front of the pass.
There was the shot setting up the drive, but Jones just didn't have his hands ready. Nice pass.
Profit, did he walk? Skip down there on the baseline. So Georgia Tech has found themselves in a hole a couple of times, but they fought back to within four.
State Farm presents Rules of the Game.
Today we're talking about setting a screen against a moving opponent. The rules have specific requirements about setting screens against moving opponents. Is this screen legal?
Sorry now.
Some people buy cut-rate car insurance, figuring they'll probably never have a claim. But then, something goes wrong, and there's no State Farm agent to turn to for help. So, the choice is yours. Go with a State Farm agent who will be there for you, or go it alone.
The player setting the screen in this play allows sufficient time and distance for the opponent being screened to stop or change direction. This is a legal screen.
Rules of the Game has been brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
For centuries, our kings were cursed.
The sedans had narrow handrails, making them hard to control in the corners. Sadly, many kings lost their thrones. Eventually, it was learned, wider is better.
With its speed-sensitive steering technology, the Wightrack Grand Prix gives you precise control of the corners.
Ancient scriptures still read, your young boy, Takito.
Wider is better. The Wightrack Grand Prix by Pontiac.
Maryland leading by four here, trying to become the number two seed in the ACC tournament. The top seed belongs to the Duke Blue Devils, and you will see more of Duke this week on ESPN and ESPN2. Elton Brand and Corey Maggette, Trajan Langdon. His lip will be a little fatter than that the next time you see him, as Coach K's club trying to go to 16-0 in ACC play. You'll see them at DePaul at United Center on Wednesday. I'll be there to bring you that one. Then North Carolina on ESPN2 coming up next weekend. Then it's the ACC tournament also. You'll see on ESPN or ESPN2 the 4th through the 7th in Charlotte. So if you have not seen the top-ranked team in the country, you've been obviously living in a cave, but you'll see more of them this week and all their remaining games on either ESPN or the Deuce. Brad Nessler and Jay Billis and our Deuce crew in Atlanta, 18-14. Our score here, quick timeout.
Georgia Tech unable to get the ball in, so they had to call a timeout. Tony Akins is a guy that is really important for this Georgia Tech team. Just a freshman, the left-hander running the point. for Bobby Kremins. You can see in wins, he is much more efficient than in losses. That's how important from the point guard position he is to this team. And he is the next in a long line of great freshman point guards that Bobby Kremins has brought into this program.
Danny Miller knocks the ball out of bounds. LeBerry's in there now in the backcourt. There's actually a three-guard offense for Georgia Tech, and they're still having trouble with this press. LeBerry will try to get it in, and Ashley Kelly lost the handle. Miller feeds Dixon. And in and out. Ball comes free. T.J. Vine, smallest guy on the court, comes up with a rebound and is fouled by Martasic.
Both Martasic and Watkins trying to keep that ball alive up on the glass. It looked like they might get it. But a nice job by Vines to come away with it. Here's Juan Dixon putting the ball on the floor. Showed pretty good strength getting that up there because Vines really grabbed it away from him, or almost did. And when that ball was loose, T.J. Vines just went up and battled and beat everybody to it.
Bobby Kremins trying to give Jason Collier a breather. Ashley Kelly, little use, kicks outside to Akins. Tony Akins has been struggling with a shot, as I said. And I think the rigors, Jay, of the ACC are getting to the freshmen a little bit.
Yeah, you can hit the wall very easily in February. It happens to seniors as well as freshmen.
Ooh, LeBerry got taken down hard. No foul called. But Tech will maintain possession under their own hoop.
One of the things you want your players to do, whether you're Gary Williams or Bobby Kremins, is to keep fighting through fatigue. And certainly that's easier said than done. But whenever you hit February, you know that players are going to be tired. They're going to have nagging injuries. But it's the guys that can fight through that that oftentimes have the most success.
Watch Georgia Tech's Louisville game last week, and it seemed like every jump shot Tony Akins took hit the front of the rim. Like, just plain fatigue has gotten him at this stage. And now Georgia Tech not only turns it over, but comes up with a foul going the other way. T.J. Vines gets his first.
Yeah, that's a good point that you make, Brad. It's not just the fact that he's playing so many more games than he did in high school. He's playing so many more minutes. I mean, Tony Akins plays 35 minutes a game. Bobby Kremins cannot afford to have him sitting over beside him, but it's the same for Jason Floyd and Alvin Jones. They both play 35 minutes a game as well. So sometimes they have to pace themselves, which you don't like to see.
Three of the top players with minutes played. Great backdoor lob to Danny Miller, who went up and got it.
Boy, he has got terrific hops. The second best player coming out of the state of New Jersey last season. Number one was Al Harrington, who went in the first round of the Indiana Pacers.
Vines down to Jones. See if he backs in. 6 points and six rebounds so far. Nice move by Alvin. It just doesn't fall for him. And now he's holding his ankle.
Always seems to have a problem with that one particular ankle when he goes down, but a nice move inside by Alvin Jones. I think he'll be all right. Just scared him a little.
And he's going to have to stop. John Clockerty says, take your time. 6-point Maryland lead, almost the midway point of this ball game. We've got more action coming up tonight on ESPN2. The Golden Eagles of Marquette and Memphis, Conference USA matchup, 7 o'clock tonight on ESPN2. ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, Go.com.
So Jones will take a seat. John Babel will replace him. And now the trainer's over there taking a look at that left ankle.
Wide open, Morris. And Babel fights for the rebound. Good positioning by John Babel. Georgia Tech trailing by six. Tony Akins, and again, almost turned it over. And the foul on Danny Miller.
Akins looked like he slipped there, taking that ball inside. He wanted to spin and try to get to the basket, but his foot went out from under.
The Georgia Tech fans expecting Tony Akins to become the next coming of, you name the list of point guards. Mark Price, Travis Best, Kenny Anderson, Stephon Marbury, Craig Neal, you go down the list. And he's not any of those yet. T.J. Vines hangs in the air, hangs on the vine, and drops it in.
Georgia Tech has got to get some scoring from somewhere, and T.J. Vines, a good three-point shooter. They're showing he can put it on the ground.
Wow. Marasic backed up and buried the jumper.
Well, he's not afraid to shoot it, and he's a guy that can really step forward. He's got all the skills to do it. He showed it last year when he had 12 points and 9 rebounds against number one North Carolina in their win at Cole.
Jason Floyd for three. Yes.
And that's where you got to find Jason Floyd, spotting up for those threes. Akins did a nice job of finding him.
Jason Floyd at home. I was talking about how well he shoots at Alexander Memorial Coliseum, and he strips the ball from Miller, but Duke Etzel's going to call a foul on him, and that's going to bring the crowd to life as they thought it was a clean steal. Floyd, though, has hit 24 of his last 40 three-pointers at home. That's how much better he shoots at home than he does on the road.
Well, you got to start thinking about not taking him on road trips.
Just leave him home. 9:06 to go in the half. Georgia Tech keeps hanging around. Trailing by only three, and Bobby Kremins can only smile. He wasn't too crazy about the last call, so Danny Miller.
And plus, he didn't think Miller was into his shooting motion, but he's going to the line for two. Miller is going to be a terrific player. Got terrific bounce to his step, very good athletically. He can shoot the ball. He's going to mature into a fine player in this league.
Francis checks back in with Miller and Stokes, Morris and Martisic. Well, the Georgia Tech fans get their wish. He rocked both of those off the side of the rim.
That's where you say the basketball gods were on our side.
That's right. Aikens crossover dribble, leaves it out to Vines. Francis got back on him, or he would have gotten a three-point shot away, and Georgia Tech throws it away again.
Awfully difficult pass through a sea of hands in the lane. And Jason Collier has racked up a fair number of turnovers just in this first half.
Yes, he has. And every time Georgia Tech makes a push to make it a two-point game, one-point game, or maybe try to tie it up, they turn it over. Virtually every trip down that they've had that opportunity. But they're still playing the number five team in the country to a three-pointer here. Nice hustle by Tony Aikens. Ball still loose. And it comes out of there. Vines picks it up. And now a whistle and a foul before the shot. It's going to be on Steve Francis.
It will be on Francis. And Vines a little bit upset. He thought that Francis went after him a little bit too aggressively on that last play. And that ball is loose. Everybody is going after it hard. LaRon Prophet doing a nice job of getting on the floor. And then Francis comes in from nowhere. But he should have kept it, maybe even called a timeout. Instead, he tried to pass it out, and Vines just stepped in there. Without that foul, that would have been an easy two for Georgia Tech.
And the foul was called before Vines got in a shooting motion of any kind. So Georgia Tech out of bounds. Collier.
Nice move.
Double dips inside. TJ Vines gave up the open shot. Collier on the baseline. Got the roll.
Good ball movement by Georgia Tech. And Jason Collier, when he catches it, he's ready to shoot it.
Georgia Tech back to within one. Morris takes Babel inside, and it's Martisic, same spot, different result this time. Rebound, Jason Floyd. Georgia Tech at the 8-minute mark, a chance to take the lead.
And Georgia Tech has really stepped up their intensity on the defensive end.
Aikens for the lead, way short, blocked out there by Morris. And on the other end, offensive foul, wave it off. And Morris got a block on one end and high off the glass. And with 7:45 remaining first half, Maryland clinging now to a one-point lead.
Dodge Neon is designed for fun in the fast lane. And now it's exceptionally easy to get up to speed during the Neon clearance. With your choice of either a $1,500 cash allowance or low 1.9 financing. Dodge Neon. All the fun without paying too big a price. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
If you expect the future to be wonderful, then you can count on a company that quietly has been preparing for it. Right here in your own backyard, with the finest customer care, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Because the future doesn't take nights and weekends off. Expect amazing, proven technology. Expect to be exhilarated. Cox Communications. Expect the best.
Big East tournament games ever. Just call 1-800-CLASSIC to get ESPN Classic. It's conference tournament time, and we're getting you ready with ESPN Classic's Classic Championship Weekend. Jordan, Ewing, Sampson, Allen, Iverson, taking you to school. It's a full weekend of old-school ACC and Big East tournament action that'll leave you swishing for more. But to see it, you gotta get ESPN Classic. To get ESPN Classic, call 1-800-CLASSIC today. Are you old school?
Maryland by one with 7:45 left in this one. And our ESPN cameras will be in College Park Wednesday night at 7 o'clock Eastern. These same fifth-ranked Terrapins return to action against the Clemson Tigers. Last time they met, Maryland won in OT. Then at 9, top-ranked Duke. Raging Langan, Elton Brand and company travel to United Center to meet DePaul. Duke trying to go to 16-0 in the ACC. They'll have to wait on that for later in the week against Carolina. But to see the rest of top-ranked Duke's games on either ESPN or ESPN2 the rest of the year, for more, log on to ESPN.com, part of Go Network, Go.com.
That Clemson-Maryland matchup, and I know you remember how close it was to being a Clemson-Maryland ACC tournament final last year.
Here's the steal and the lay-in by Proffitt. If you turn it over against Maryland, you're going to pay on the other end.
Yeah, they're so fast the other way, and they do a nice job of finishing at the goal. LaRon Proffitt takes the ball to the basket hard, so does Steve Francis, as well as Terrence Morris.
Alvin Jones back in there with the ankle retapes. And he's fouled.
Maryland foul by LaRon Proffitt. That's his first.
LaRon Proffitt has such great hands defensively. Not only does he move his feet very well, but he's active with his hands, and that's one of the big reasons he is in the top 10 now, all-time ACC steals.
234, and the next guy he catches is Mark Price, who played right here at Georgia Tech, who had 240 in his brilliant Yellow Jacket career.
Remember the knock on Price coming out when he was going to the NBA was he was too slow?
Too slow.
But he had 240 steals. Apparently, we were just giving the ball to him.
That's right. Just retired officially right here at the Coliseum a week ago Friday. Had the announcement here and still makes Atlanta his home.
What a great player he was both in college and the pros.
And you played against him. And we talked about John Sally earlier that Alvin Jones has tied his shot block record, and you played against John all 4 years.
Yeah, and I gave him plenty of those blocks.
Morris, and there's a block shot by Collier instead of Jones. 29th time Jason Collier sent one back at the opposition.
Collier might be a better shot blocker if Jones weren't on his team, because Jones blocks him before he can get to him.
Good point. Maryland by one. They have led ever since we were tied at 2-2 when they took the 4-2 lead. They have not been headed again.
Well, one of the things Jason Collier needs to do is become a better rebounder, a little bit more physical.
Absolutely. Steve Francis, with the shot clock running down, had to pump one from three-point land. Here's Georgia Tech, again a chance to lead if they don't turn it over. That's been their MO so far, every chance they've had. Jones, nice kick out to Floyd. And Collier had his hands on it, and Francis just swiped it from him.
Francis averages about 4 or 5 rebounds a game, and when he gets one, he's able to push it.
Terrell trying to stoke it and missed it. And now a foul on Floyd after Baxter picked up the rebound.
You talk about taking up space inside. That's exactly what Lonnie Baxter does. He is so wide and so strong, not extraordinarily quick, but he's just able to get his considerable rear end into you and move you around the court.
Approaching the 6-minute mark.
Not a whole lot of movement offensively for Maryland. A lot of standing around.
Francis looks at Gary Williams and now makes his move to the basket.
Nobody's
and it's
back.
Stripped out of there by Vines. And the outlet to T.J. Vines for a Georgia Tech lead. Yes, they got it. It went in anyway. So the goaltending would not have mattered. That ball dropped in, and T.J. Vines has given Georgia Tech a 1-point lead.
Nobody got back for Maryland. When Steve Francis found that he had Alvin Jones on him, he went into a 1-4 set to try to take Jones to the basket, and nobody rotated back defensively.
Georgia Tech's defense, as Jay Billis pointed out earlier, is what's gotten them back not only in this game, but in front of this game. And there's a nice overplay by Collier.
And that's where Ekezi's loss hurts them. Ekezi would have held Collier off there. Baxter doesn't have the experience yet. He'll get it.
Alvin Jones wants it down low against Baxter. And the hook shot goes. Not a bad looking move.
George Mikan lives. Yeah, that shot is so effective, and so few guys really use it anymore. Great play by Jones.
Proffitt in the paint, fouled. I think it's Floyd, and if it is, that's 3 on him. It'll take him out of the remainder of this half.
Well, not all Jason Floyd's fault. Somebody's got to come over from the weak side and cut off that middle and try to stop LaRon Proffitt from getting all the way to the basket. You can't always expect Jason Floyd to be able to stay in front of a great player like LaRon Proffitt, who is so good at putting the ball on the floor and getting to the rack.
So Jason Floyd and John Babel, two starters sitting side by side. Babel with 2 fouls, Floyd with 3. And Darryl O'Berry is going to check in for him right now as Proffitt missed the free throw. Juan Dixon back into the ballgame for Maryland. The first player in the ACC out of Calvert Hall High School since Dwayne Farrell played here at Georgia Tech.
Dwayne Farrell, great player here and still making money in the NBA.
Proffitt got the second of two.
Number 15, Danny Miller.
Here's the 1-2-1-1 press. 2-point Georgia Tech lead as we approach 5 minutes. Vital game for Georgia Tech to have any hopes of an NCAA tournament bid. They need this upset, and it would be huge, but a long ways to go. Jones lost the handle. Here comes Maryland, 4-on-1.
Great Francis!
How many 6'9 guys make a play like Terrence Morris just did? Not only running the court, but that little touch pass back to Steve Francis for the electrifying finish. That's just great basketball.
Francis 6'3, and those dunks make him look like a 7'3.
Reminds you a little bit of Johnny Dawkins in the old days, doesn't it?
Man. Inside, Dixon with a lay-in on the baseline. And just like that, Maryland ties it up and has a chance to lead.
They're so explosive. Yeah, Alvin Jones puts the ball on the floor. Everybody converges down on him. They slap it away. A nice catch by Dixon. Squares his shoulders. Gets the bump from Vines, but still has the presence to put it up with his left hand. And Juan Dixon, a young man who is going to be a very good player. He is fearless out on the court. Has the ability to hit the deep jumper.
Dixon has given Maryland back a three-point lead just like that.
Usually after a free throw, that's when Maryland likes to put on their 1-2-1-1, but it looks like they're going man pressure here.
Barry not as accustomed to handling that ball against the press, but he does a nice job against Miller.
And that's what they want in the pressure, to have guys who aren't used to handling it, and having to make plays on the run.
Francis overplaying Tony Akins, trying to make him go to his right. Babel down low, kicks out to LeBarry. He's a pretty good outside shooter. Francis, wow, was he up for that rebound. Dixon lobs. Oh, what a shot by Terrence Moore.
Are you kidding me? The soft hands to be able to lay that in off the glass. He's just too nonchalant about that. They should stop the game and give him a standing O.
Inside, Babel right back out to Vines. Akins just can't get one to drop. Dixon off the carom, bringing it in a hurry. Francis is wide open for three. Got it. Wow. Talk about explosion. Francis with a three-pointer, and Georgia Tech, after having a three-point lead, has seen that not only evaporate, but they trail by eight again.
That was a terrific look cross-court by Juan Dixon to find the open Steve Francis for the spot-up jump shot. It's not enough anymore just to get back in transition and protect the basket. Here's that great pass by Dixon to Terrence Morris with that soft right hand to catch the ball and lay it in. Juan Dixon, two possessions, two terrific passes.
Last time I've seen 11 points in a row scored this quickly, I think it was when I was doing Auburn a couple of weeks ago, and it was 2-2 or 4-4, and all of a sudden it was 20-4 over at Auburn.
Boy, what a great story the Auburn Tigers are this year, the SEC regular season champions, 25-1. They were 16-14 last season, unranked coming into the year. And right now they're looking at being number two in the country.
They'll be number two tomorrow, thanks to UConn's loss to Miami yesterday. Congratulations to Cliff Ellis, longtime ACC coach, 10 years at Clemson. Collier gets a goaltending call on the hook shot. Collier with 10. Georgia Tech trailing, though, by 6, courtesy of a big Maryland run.
Battle stations.
Karate ships are closing.
To fight a new breed of enemy.
What is this thing?
Earth's last hope is a new generation of warrior.
Lieutenant Christopher Blair.
Todd, Maniac Marshall.
I got two bogeys coming in hot.
Let's do it.
Freddie Prinze Jr. Saffron Burroughs. Matthew Lillard. Jackie Cario. Wing Commander.
I love this baby.
Rated PG-13. March 12th only in theaters.
Tim and Ed are neighbors, sort of. You see, Ed thought Tim's hair was too long, and Tim thought Ed's pants were too short. Then Tim brought home the new redesigned 260-horse Ford Mustang GT, just when Ed was pulling out his Boss 302.
Nice Mustang.
You too.
Wow. Just think if everyone owned a Mustang.
And the world will be a better place for you.
Ford Mustang GT, built to last.
Craig, I don't know.
Fair enough. Maybe this'll help.
As you can see, I love you more than anything in the world.
Note the dramatic increase in the past 7 months. This shows how much we have in common. My 10-year gross earnings potential. A composite of what our kids might look like.
I like what you've done here, Craig.
Sometimes it's not just what you say, but how you say it. Kinko's. Express yourself.
Well, the ACC tournament just around the corner, the NCAA tourney to follow. You try to keep your team focused, but Gary Williams says, you know, you can't hide it from your players. They know what's coming.
Well, I think there's so much attention drawn to it by the media. You have to address it with your team. And, you know, the most important thing is that we've talked to our team about is if you win when you play, then that's all you can do. You can't do any more than that. And so let's not take away preparing for one individual game, worried about what's going to happen at the end of the year, because if we take care of business ourselves, we'll be in good shape at the end of the year.
Right now, Maryland is taking care of business, leading by six after an 11-point run after Georgia Tech had regained the lead in this one.
And what a terrific job Gary Williams has done with this team all season long. 22-4.
And in the top 10 all season.
Yeah, he should be right there for Coach of the Year. And there's Brian Watkins, who is a very good perimeter shooter. What's kept him out of the lineup, the transfer from Notre Dame, has just been defense and rebounding. He can score.
Lead goes back to eight. Bynes tied up by Stokes. Nope, fouled by Stokes.
Yeah, that's a good call because he had his arms wrapped around him. And that's always been a question with me, is how you can tie up the ball and get a jump ball with only one hand. And that is called from time to time, but Jim Burr right on top of that call.
Tony Akins in. Jason Floyd forced to sit back down.
Maryland substitution number 23, Steve Francis.
Steve Francis checking back in. Stokes with two foul sits.
Yeah, you get back to the job that Gary Williams has done with this team. Yeah, it might be that Pete Gillen, because of the terrific job he's done at Virginia, gets ACC Coach of the Year this year. Who knows? But I think when you take a team that is expected to do well and do well, you should get some consideration as well, and that's Gary Williams.
That's leaving out Mike Krzyzewski at Duke. He's doing a pretty good job, too.
He certainly is. It should certainly be right up there.
Georgia Tech forces a turnover. Laverry found himself a little avenue, but Dixon swatted it away. Ahead to Profit on the run. Collier's going to make him earn it.
Boy, that's what you call a confrontation at the rim, taking it right to a seven-footer. And it shows you a little bit of how strong Laron Profit is. Watch where Jason Collier winds up after this. Profit taking it, and Collier hits him. And then Elton John, I'm still standing. And Jason Collier on his backside. Laron Profit, awfully strong.
Laron Profit, 6 points today, 1,464 for his career. When you put that in with his assists, we talked about his steals, block shots, over 500 rebounds. Been an all-around player for Maryland.
And has just been a great player throughout his career. A guy who's been overlooked this season because of the explosion of Steve Francis, the emergence of Terrence Morris. But he's a guy who's been steady for his 4 years in a Terp uniform.
Georgia Tech is in a danger zone right now. They turn it over. Profit with yet another steal and another chance to go to the free throw line.
You know, Laron Profit did something very smart there. After the terrific steal, the nice anticipation to jump out in the gap and steal the ball. He went off of 2 feet there. He could feel Daryl LeBerry coming down the middle. Had he gone off of 1 foot, he would have really exposed himself to getting fouled hard and getting hurt. Instead, he went off 2 feet and was able to set himself, go up strong, and perhaps complete a three-point play. That's a good play by a senior.
And got the roll on the free throw. After missing his first free throw, he's hit four straight.
And one thing you notice about Maryland in this first half, they've gotten so much in transition, they have rarely had to go against Georgia Tech's half-court defense. When they have gone against it, they've struggled a little bit. That's why you want to try to keep from turning it over and feeding their offense.
Again, the quick hands of Profit. He picked up the foul there, but just Maryland reaching across the body. Three, you had better be strong with the ball when you play Maryland, or you are going to turn it over time after time.
Maryland in the midst right now of a 17-2 run. LeBarry to try to halt that at least momentarily from the free throw line. LeBarry's only a 59% free throw shooter, and Georgia Tech as a team has not done well from the stripe.
Maryland coaching staff just telling Ron Profit to be smart this last minute 53. He's got two fouls, doesn't want to pick up the third before they go into halftime.
Francis slows down to hear some words from Gary Williams and points at himself. I don't know if that means he's going to be the man to take one this trip down or not. Nope, it's Profit on the turn. Boy, LaRon Profit's taken over here in the last 2 minutes.
Yeah, he started off the season 1-for-18 from three, but since then has shot about 49%. Starting to show the complete package as a player. And once you had a jump shot, he's a formidable force.
Collier's going to try a three. Up high for the rebound is Watkins. Profit, he's feeling it, still is. Maryland playing great right now.
And transition defense has been a real problem for Georgia Tech, not only getting back to protect the paint, but fanning out to open shooters.
It's going to be 25-3.
This has just been a Terp explosion in the first half. They've done it defensively, scoring off of their defense.
Totally have taken, obviously, the Georgia Tech crowd out of this game when once they led, now they find themselves in an 18-point hole. Coming up at halftime, ESPN News will bring you stories on Michigan-Indiana, women's ACC matchup. Other scores and highlights, that's all about 32 seconds away.
Let's go.
And John Clockerty, I think, has got a contact lens problem. He found it, he just hasn't put it back in yet, I think. Needs a little solution.
Otherwise, there's only five eyes out there.
Some people would say there's not enough eyes out there to start with in the first place.
Got to have at least six. It's in the rule book. Well, this is one way to stop the Maryland momentum.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, if you are playing against Maryland, you have really got to be concerned that you don't allow them to score so much off their defense. You know, when you turn the ball over, they're allowed to get easy baskets in transition. You're just feeding the fire. It's like pouring gasoline on it. You've got to make them into a half-court team. I think that's one of the only ways that you can beat Maryland is to make them play half-court basketball and work against your half-court defense. Now, they've only lost. They've lost to Duke twice. They lost at Rupp Arena in December.
And lost to Wake.
And they lost that blip on the radar screen, that unusual loss that they had at Wake Forest.
When they admittedly kind of did a sleepwalk through that game.
And credit certainly to Wake Forest for a terrific win. And one that may help them get into the NCAA tournament as the fourth team from this league. They're really in the best position to do that. They're 6-8.
Rebound.
John might take the rest of the half off.
Now, if he blows the whistle from there, I think you can say he's out of position. If you blow it in the tunnel, you are clearly out of position to make the call.
Oh, 20-second timeout, 32 seconds left in the half. The ACC standings again. Duke has DePaul Wednesday and then Carolina next weekend, trying to become the first team to go 16-0. And a lot of people have said a historic feat that would be. Well, the problem is there wasn't always 16 games in the ACC.
Yeah.
So
it's historic in the sense that nobody's ever done it before.
Right.
But I would hesitate to say that Michael Jordan and his crew that went undefeated in the league in 1984, if you added Florida State in there, couldn't have done that.
Right.
So it's a great achievement, but it's just circumstantial that there are now 16 games.
Duke down the stretch. You'll see them against Pat Kennedy's young DePaul team. I'll be there to bring you that one. North Carolina on the deuce next Saturday, then the ACC tournament in Charlotte, and pretty much all of us will be there to bring you not only Duke's game, but the other matchups in the ACC tourney as well. 17-point Maryland lead when just minutes ago, they trailed by three. Laurent Prophet, Steve Francis, and Terrence Morris have been big-time damage to Georgia Tech. And now underneath, Dixon got it away from Collier. Reverse layup. At the buzzer. What a run by Maryland. As the Terrapins outscore Georgia Tech 26-4 at the end of the first half of play. And at halftime, fifth-ranked Maryland 50. Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets 31 here in Atlanta.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball is brought to you by E-Trade. Someday, we'll all invest this way. And by Ford Mustang, a new breed of Mustang that's reborn to run.
I heard this story about a group of tourists who were searching for Western heroes.
Come on, baby.
And they got a little off track.
We're sunk.
Luckily, their hero found them.
Guarda!
The legendary Ford F-150.
Gary Cooper!
Yeah, Gary Cooper!
Looks like he could use a hand.
With an available 5.4-liter Triton V8 that delivers more pulling power than Dodge or Chevy. Now there's a happy ending. Ford F-Series, built for tough.
So, how's the broker biz?
Hey, my client made $2,000 on the market, and he owed it all to me.
What, did you give him some good advice?
No, I meant he owed it to me. In commissions.
Who's looking out for your investments? E-Trade, the number one rated place to invest online. Get free real-time quotes, 10 times more research, IPOs, all from $14.95. Isn't it time you looked out for number one? Call 1-800-ETRADE-1 and see why someday we'll all invest this way.
Where do they find this one?
Chapel Hill.
Toxicology?
Negative.
From the worldwide leader in sports, this is ESPN News.
Dan, welcome to ESPN News, everybody. I'm Ian Page. A special welcome to those of you watching us on ESPN2. You're watching that Maryland-Georgia Tech game, a good battle in the ACC. We'll get you back to the second half of the game in just a few moments, but first, here's what else is happening around college basketball today. Well, ever since Bobby Knight came to Bloomington, Indiana, there really has been no place like home for the Hoosiers. As heading into this season, over the last 27 years, Indiana had won 84% of its Big Ten home games. This year, however, the Hoosiers have stumbled to a 3-3 mark at Assembly Hall against conference teams. This afternoon, Indiana tries to win one at home against Michigan, but let's get a check on the Big Ten standings before we get to that game. And as you can see here, Michigan State will wrap up its first outright Big Ten title in 9 years with a win today against Wisconsin. But other than second place and maybe third place, as you can see here, spots 4-8 definitely up for grabs. Now let's get you that Michigan-Indiana game, and Indiana down by 5 early as Larry Richardson takes the feed, jamming it down, but Michigan's up by 3 early. Then Luke Recker takes the pass from A.J. Guyton and scores down low. Indiana on top by 7 at the half. Second half, Lewis Bullock gets around Lewis and puts it up off the glass to pull Michigan within 5, and we can check on the score now. It's 68-66, as you can see it change before your eyes. With about 4 minutes to go in regulation, it's a 2-point Indiana lead as Michigan has lost 2 straight games and 7 of their last 8, but they are hanging tough with Indiana this afternoon. Elsewhere in the Big Ten, they are just about to tip Iowa and Illinois, as Illinois has 11 straight wins over the Hawkeyes at home. As Iowa, they've lost 6 of their last 9 games since getting off to that impressive 13-1 start. And the marquee matchup in college basketball today takes place in the Big Ten as Michigan State will host Wisconsin. This one will tip at 4:30 Eastern time as Michigan State is on a 13-game winning streak. Well, Rutgers is on the brink of a remarkable resurgence as the Scarlet Knights went to the Final Four back in 1976, but they have not been to the NCAA tournament since 1991, and they haven't played a postseason game since an NIT appearance in 92. But this year it's 17-8 and 9-6 in the Big East with three games to go. Rutgers could get an invitation to the big dance today. Rutgers playing an important game against their rival, Seton Hall. And early in this one, Shaheen Holloway, the steal and the layup. That caps off an 11-0 run. The Hall up by 9 at that point. Rutgers coming back, though. Jeff Billett, this guy can stroke the three. He does it right there. Rutgers within 2 late in the game. Under 20 seconds to go now. Rutgers down 2, and Rob Hodgson drives to the hole, but Holloway knocks it away from him. Out of bounds off of Hodgson. And Seton Hall and Holloway hang on for the win by 2 today. 57-55, the Hall's 10th win in their last 12 meetings with Rutgers, as Chuck Moore had 13 points for the Pirates. And we check on the standings in the Big East, as UConn could have wrapped up at least a tie for the Big East title yesterday, but of course they lost to Miami. Rutgers now 9-7 in the Big East, as they just lost to Seton Hall, as we just showed you. Meantime, Syracuse playing a big out-of-conference battle today against UCLA. They will tip it off at 3:30 Eastern time. This will be the first meeting between these two schools, as UCLA 3-4 against ranked teams this year. They've lost 2 of their last 3 ball games. And West Virginia and Notre Dame. They're in the first half. It's a 10-point Notre Dame lead right now, as West Virginia, by the way, has 16 losses. That ties a school record. Notre Dame trying to snap a 3-game losing streak. And also in the Atlantic 10, it's St. Joseph's and Rhode Island in a close one, as St. Joseph's lost 9 of their last 10 overall, while Rhode Island beat St. Joseph's by 14 about a month ago. They have won 3 straight ball games. In the SEC, it's Alabama and Vanderbilt. And early on in this one, the alley-oop to Lange. Good pass and a soft dunk. And then Tariq London coming up with the steal. And Terrence Martin out ahead of the pack. He will miss the layup, but that's okay. Jeremy Hayes slams it down. We're tied at 27 in this one. And then first half winding down. DeAndre Moore feeds Lange the pump fake, and he hits the off-balance jumper. He had 18 in the first half to put Vandy up 47-35. This is now a 5-point game in the second half, as Vandy only 3-10 overall in the SEC. Alabama, by the way, has lost 5 of their last 7 ball games. And Maryland up 50-31 on Georgia Tech at the half. We're coming back with more scores and highlights after this.
This is the final morning call from Flight 7.
How many sugars do you want?
Oh, I'll take 2. Hey, look at the little telephone.
Keep your eye on him. He'll be over every day to use it.
That's okay. Just as long as he dials 1010-321 first.
Isn't 1010-321 great? You should see how low my phone bill is.
And now it's even better, you know. Saves 50% off calls over 10 minutes.
Right, day or night. So I save big on all my most important calls.
Like when I call my boyfriend in New York.
Right, like when you call your boyfriend in New York. Wait a minute, boyfriend? You got a boyfriend?
For Dan and Lisa, it just clicked. So they loaded up their Ford Expedition and got back to doing what they loved, answering the call of the wild.
I lost them.
And they unleashed a beast of their own. That big 5.4-liter Triton V8.
Gotcha.
And you thought Little Red Riding Hood got a close look. Ford Expedition.
Built Ford tough.
Killer outfit. Too bad the nightlife sucks. Dracula returns to Castlevania on Nintendo 64 from Konami.
When sports cream? When legs are sore? When backs ache? When muscles hurt? Why sports cream? Rubbing it in brings fast pain relief. No medicine-y smell. Why sports cream? Because it works.
Women's college hoop from the ACC, North Carolina and Duke. First half action, Hillary Howard with the crossover dribble. And then look at the nice layup by her. Duke on top by five. And then Juana Brown missing the three. Duke's Pepe Brown comes up with the rebound. UNC, though, forces the turnover. And Laquanda Barksdale gets the hoop and the foul. She had 14 points in the first half. And then Carolina up by two. Nikki Teasley with the baseline move. And she uses the window. But North Carolina ends up losing by 10 to Duke, as Duke has won 18 of their last 19. They've already clinched first place in the ACC. George Washington and Virginia Tech, and Christina Alexander going for the win at the buzzer, in and out. She can't get it to go as Virginia Tech hangs on to win by two as they get their fifth straight win over the GW Colonials. For those of you on ESPN2, you'll go back to the second half of the Terrapins and Yellow Jackets. For those of you on ESPN News, I'm coming back with more scores and highlights after this.
They clean them. They polish them. They lavish them with extras. Maybe the reason Dodge Ram owners take such good care of their trucks is that their trucks take such good care of them. And now, Ram is J.D. Power & Associates' most appealing full-size pickup for the fourth consecutive year. The rules have changed.
Being a working mom isn't easy. Every day is a challenge. The time I spend with my kids is important. I know that. The Arizona Department of Education has a program that encourages parents to take a half hour with their kids each day and learn the importance of good study habits. It's called HUG, and you should know about it. Give your kids a hug today and every day. HUG, 30 minutes a day can last a lifetime. A message from the Arizona Department of Education.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield, even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Maryland by 19 at halftime. At the 5:23 mark, Georgia Tech had a three-point lead, 27-24. Brad Nessler and Jay Billis back. Jay, from that point on, Maryland just steamrolled it.
And Maryland did it with their defense. They forced 14 turnovers in that first half and got 11 steals. Maryland was just all over the place defensively. And when they were able to turn over Georgia Tech, they got some easy things in transition. But it just wasn't off their defense. It was off missed shots. Here you can see Juan Dixon pushing the ball up court, looking opposite to Steve Francis, who was ready to shoot, coming down, spotting up on the break. And Brian Watkins, after he gets this rebound, immediately finds the outlet man, and there's Dixon again looking behind him. And LaRon Proffitt had it rolling in that first half. 14 points for Proffitt, 15 points for Steve Francis.
Maryland went 9 of 12 in that last 5 minutes 20 seconds, a 26-4 run, and they lead by 19.
Don't know much about history, don't know much biology.
Nothing helps you kick back at the end of the day like Tostitos chips and salsa. We do suggest you actually try waiting till the end of the day.
Now let's release the snakes.
Dig in, kick back with new hint of lime Tostitos for a whole new twist.
I, gosh, you know, I just went to use the phone.
You say once you got back, your wife was gone.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
What?
Have you checked the hot enchilada?
Oh, no. Millicent gets terrible heartburn.
Not this time.
What's that?
Looks like the remains of one of those new Pepcid AC chewables.
Now the first chewable that stops heartburn before it starts. Great-tasting Pepcid AC chewables.
Millicent? Is that you?
Start living heartburn-free with new Pepcid AC chewables.
It is uniquely human, the need to connect, to be a part of something larger. Today, it all starts with a .com address.
Hey, Grandpa?
Network Solutions puts more .com addresses into service than every other internet company combined. Yeah. Want to get connected to the internet?
first. Get connected to Network Solutions. Network Solutions, the .com people.
Get ready to taste life for the first time, people.
Watch out now. You want to taste life? Then take a big swig of this new Pepsi One. This one's got it all. The most awesome cola taste that's bigger than the Wild Blue Yonder. But only one calorie. You want to taste one?
Yeah.
You want to taste one?
One gallon. Only one has it all.
Regular cola drinkers, diet drinkers, everyone loves the taste. Try it. Tell us what you think, and you could be on your way to the NCAA Final Four.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Volvo. Volvo for life.
50-31, fifth-ranked Maryland leading the Yellow Jackets at halftime and shooting 53% so far in the ballgame. And look at the points off turnover. They have doubled Georgia Tech. The big run at the end of the half. What turned the tide in this ballgame? Here's the big guns, Jay.
And look at Terrence Morris. Very quietly, he had 8 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists, 2 steals, and 2 blocks in that first half. And nobody even knew he was out there.
Laurent Prophet, part of that explosion near the end of the half. Tony Akins today, we talked about the barometer, and if it was a thermometer, he'd be in the deep freeze right now. He's 0 for 6 and hasn't scored. John Babel with a steal to open the second half, and believed he was tripped by Steve Francis inadvertently, and Jim Burr says, Steve, I'm sorry, I got to call it on you.
And took a big bump on that left knee as he went down. He is limping as well. Yesterday I was up in Amherst, Massachusetts, got to see John's twin brother Mike play for the Minutemen and Bruiser Flint. We had a big win in double overtime over Xavier.
Collier threw it away. Stokes got an easy one. First basket for Terrell Stokes. And just a lazy pass, and that's why Bobby Crimmins is shaking his head right now.
Well, he's shaking his head because that's the 8th turnover for Jason Collier, matching what had to be his season high against Maryland last time these two teams played, but he's still got 19 more minutes to go.
Jones and Akins play catch on the low block on the left side. Tony Akins, now he's not scoreless. Hits a three. Gotta get back. Francis, the dish and the leave. And Baxter almost brought the rim down.
Yeah, what did that remind you of there? That was a little bit of Celtics basketball, wasn't it?
Yeah.
They score on you, you get it right out and go the other way and just totally deflate whatever momentum they may have.
Another lazy pass, this one by Floyd, and last touch by Jones as Francis forced the turnover. Steve Francis on his 21st birthday. I saw a sign over there behind their bench. Happy birthday, Steve. 20-point lead. Here's a backdoor, trying to lob it underneath, not high enough, and Collier steals it away. And Georgia Tech gives it right back.
No pass fakes for Georgia Tech.
17 turnovers, Georgia Tech. As you said, 27 in the first matchup, and they're going to match that or worsen it if they don't be a little more careful with the basketball.
But that's what pressure does to you. It gets you going out of your normal rhythm much faster than normal. And you have to make plays on the run, which can be difficult for some guys.
Baxter with a left hand. It almost went in. Jones with a rebound.
Using that step-through move that is oftentimes called a travel, but is completely legal.
Alvin Jones, 8th rebound of the ballgame. Babel is not a big offensive threat. Rattled that one out. He should probably shoot more.
Well, he has to shoot more just to be a threat. You have to look at the basket to get guarded.
And Stokes, they gave him an opening, and he was expecting somebody to block it, put it up there too hard.
Stokes leading the ACC in assist-to-turnover ratio, been very efficient.
There's Babel in close, another chance. He's missed 3 shots in a row now.
Seems like he's just going a little bit too fast, perhaps worrying about the shot block instead of just getting it up there.
Akins comes out, trying to put a little pressure on Stokes, who handles it beautifully. Prophet got his man in the air, and he is just as hot as he was to end the first half. 16 for Laurent Prophet to lead the Terrapins, and it's a 22-point lead.
Prophet shaking his head, running the other way, sort of like Michael Jordan did against the Blazers a few years ago.
Like, hey, I can't help it, they're going in. Alvin Jones, 14 for Jones.
One thing that Maryland does not want to do here is trade baskets with Georgia Tech.
Prophet missed a three there. Babel goes to the deck.
Now, according to the rule, Maryland should probably get that because Babel had possession of it.
Georgia Tech substitute.
But it looks like they're going to call it a jump ball and go with the possession arrow as if it were simultaneous possession.
That's the flaw in that rule, without a doubt. We've seen that a million times already this year.
And we have said a million times, let's just go back to the old jump ball and jump it up.
Yeah.
You know, let's get Tony Akins against Terrence Morris in the jump ball and see what happens.
Out of bounds to Georgia Tech. The old man and the young fella. The two-point guards having a little chat there. Tony Akins out of right here in Lilburn, Georgia. And he missed the jumper off the inbound. Morris will clear it.
And much stronger on the defensive board there was Terrence Morris. When he gets some weight on him, I'm telling you, what a great player he's going
to
be.
Lob down low from Francis to Proffitt, and Vines picks up his third foul. Gary Williams, Maryland Terrapins, up by 20 with 16:39 remaining in the ball game and looking for their 23rd win of the year. Brad Nessler and Jay Billison, our ESPN2 crew with you from Atlanta. And if you missed the last 5 minutes of the first half, as Proffitt on the cut and a nice pass from Marnicic is fouled, it's going to be Vines again. Maryland just took over the last 5 minutes of the first half. They trailed by three, and at halftime they were up by 19. That's how quickly it happened.
Nice back cut here by Laurent Proffitt. No help side defense because the ball was more toward the middle of the floor. And Mike Marnicic delivers a very nice bounce pass in stride for Proffitt. And Proffitt at the line brings up to mind who is going to make all Atlantic Coast Conference this season is going to be very difficult. You'd think that Proffitt has to be considered for at least second team,
right?
But I will tell you what, Brad, I think that Terrence Morris has got to be a first team All-ACC performer. He has done it all season long against the very best competition. He's put up tremendous numbers, but he's done it so quietly and so smoothly that some writers may actually overlook him in favor of Steve Francis.
Now, when you said he's the most underrated guy, not only in the conference but the country, you're right. He's played very well again today. Proffitt and Francis, the leading scorers right now. Nice cut to the hoop by Babel. A little hook pass by Jones, who's really favoring that left ankle.
Yeah, at first I thought he would be all right just to walk that off because he's done it before in so many games, but clearly he's hurt.
Marnicic, baseline jumper over Jones. Jones comes up with the ball and is fouled by Proffitt.
That should be number three on Proffitt.
Alvin Jones on his way to his 10th double-double of the year. He has 14 points, and I've got him for 9 rebounds right now, so he's been pretty consistent.
You know, Mike Marnicic missed that shot, but it was a good move, and he is just a little bit away, I think, from being a good ACC player, able to finish plays. He's only shooting about 40% from the field, and that's something that is uncharacteristic. He'll be able to do better than that.
Jones, not much push off that ankle on the turnaround baseline jumper. Collier, is it going to be another,
it is another
turnover? It is.
So it'll be number 9 for him, and it's all because he put the ball on the floor.
And for Georgia Tech, turnover number 18. And about ready to turn this game over to Maryland.
Very good. I must say, I'm amazed. From Volvo.
Hey, let's talk New York. Let's talk pizza. Let's talk big. Like the new Big New Yorker from Pizza Hut. It's so big, it's got 3 zip codes. You need a road map to find your way across. It's so big, on the other side, it's almost Cleveland. It's a genuine street corner 16-inch New York-style pizza with 8 big floppy foldable slices dripping with cheese and tomato sauce that's really, really good. At a price that's very un-New York, $9.99. $9.99. You can't even get a taxi for that price. The Big New Yorker pizza from Pizza Hut. The best pizzas under one roof.
You heard about the High Endurance Deodorant Challenge from Old Spice? It's great at stopping odor. But what if you gotta stop sweat? Well, High Endurance makes a powerful antiperspirant. A white solid that goes on clear. See? No white flakes. So you can stay dry without the white mess you get from some other antiperspirants. Guaranteed. Or call 1-800-PROVE-IT and Old Spice will buy you a stick of yours. So take the challenge. Because this is more than just an antiperspirant. This is the high endurance of antiperspirants.
Georgia Tech trailing 57-38. Might not be the same story if that fellow wasn't in street clothes. Deion Glover, last year a sensational freshman, and now working on rehab from an injury in October.
I'm trying to be very patient and trying to wait this thing out because I know I have a whole career ahead of me in basketball, hopefully. I don't want to rush back and re-injure my leg, so I'm being patient and listening to the doctors, and they're telling me to hold off the next season.
What a difference he would have made to this Georgia Tech team that is on the verge of becoming 14-13. He's been out for the season. He was hurt in the first practice. Matter of fact, I remember I was doing a football game here in town and found out in our pregame festivities that he had been injured in practice that morning, out for the season with a knee injury, trying to urge on his teammates right now. But Georgia Tech with only 38 points now, and they're second to last in the ACC in scoring. And if Deion was in there, I don't think that'd be the case.
Yeah, he played for the gold medal winning Goodwill Games team this summer. And Phil Martelli told me, who was an assistant on that team, that he just scared the ball into the basket.
Well, we wish him well with his rehab, and obviously all the Georgia Tech fans hope that he comes back strong next year.
And you know who a role model's been for him is Baron Davis of UCLA, the way he came back from his ACL injury that he suffered in the NCAA tournament against Michigan.
Davis playing so well right now, over 15 a game. Nice little finger roll, reverse layup by Collier. His first field goal of the second half. 12 for the game.
You know, when he keeps it simple, he is such a good player. Got very good footwork along the baseline. That was a terrific move.
Nice fundamentals. Turnovers have been the big bugaboo today. Steve Francis got the triple.
Good ball movement against the zone. Georgia Tech put on what looked like a little 1-2-2, but the configuration doesn't matter. The ball movement for Maryland did.
There you saw the happy birthday card to Steve Francis, who hits his second three-pointer of the day. 18 for the ball game. Floyd, pull-up jumper. Too strong. Stokes comes out of the pile. It's a 3-on-2 for Maryland. Morris on a trailer.
I mean, he has got such great body control. He just let Jason Floyd fly past him.
And now Floyd flies too quickly, and it's another Georgia Tech turnover.
Boy, what a superior athletic play by Terrence Morris to slow down in that break.
He sort of hung there, didn't he? And then laid it in.
I can't tell you how much respect I have for this young man's ability. His development reminds you a little bit of Len Bias at Maryland. Did not have the breakout freshman year, averaged about 7 points a game. Then as a sophomore, just exploded. And with his talent, he's just going to get better and better and better.
And it's going to be scary by the time he's done. Baxter in there with Martisic, Dixon, Francis, and Miller, who's got it on the baseline.
Flex cuts, so difficult to defend.
Martisic trying to work around Collier. Got a decent shot. Alvin Jones, now he does have the double-double. His 10th of the year and playing on a really bad wheel. He is limping noticeably out there. Whistle before Collier's shot.
It'll be on Martisic inside, a little wrestling match. Or at least it should be. Oh, Jason Floyd is hurt. Jason Floyd is limping. That's why the whistle went.
Tech's running out of ankles right now.
Here's Jason Collier coming down trying to establish the early post. Gets right into Mike Martisic. And Martisic has to step forward and meet him higher up. Don't allow him that position where he can get a foot in the paint. You can force a guy off of the block, you can make his move that much more difficult. The further out on the court you can get a big guy, the more success defensively you're going to have.
62-40. The lead, the largest it's been the entire game. LeBarry will try three. And Baxter will clear off the miss.
And Jones really no help on the offensive glass. He just has to turn and watch.
Dixon floats in. Oh, man.
See, with that ankle, he can't get over to block a shot. He can't get to the glass. He's really just hobbling up and down court.
24-point Maryland lead. Collier fades on the baseline. Baxter with another rebound. Steve Francis looking down court. And Dixon's open. Got it. Not a bad little spark off the bench for the redshirt freshman, huh? 10 points for him. 67-40. The lead has swelled to 27.
With the one. Is it wrong?
Heck no. Not if you love that one-of-a-kind two-all-beef patty taste of McDonald's Big Mac.
Calling all units. Be on the lookout for the Hamburglar.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
This is a real mom-and-pop hardware store. I think we have a nice family feel. A couple of months ago, we got a little bump in our car. Well, we've been with our State Farm agent for 26 years because I think he puts his personal self into it. Just like we do at the hardware store, he actually listens to what your needs are. It makes me feel pretty important.
Get to know your State Farm agent.
You can't put a price on a good relationship.
It is built in November and melts in April. 100 miles above the Arctic Circle, Sweden's Ice Hotel proves that winter can be tamed, controlled, rather enjoyed. A realization some guests arrive at before they arrive. The all-wheel drive Volvo Cross Country.
Beautiful blue skies over the Golden Dome of the State Capitol building here in Atlanta, Georgia. And the Atlanta mayor, Bill Campbell, along with us. And Mayor Campbell gave the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets a pep talk before the game. I walked over to him at halftime. I said, Bill, you got to give him a pep talk that lasts more than 15 minutes. You got to give him the two-hour version. He's a big Tech fan, though.
Georgia Tech substitute.
He says Maryland's just too good right now, and he was upset with Georgia Tech's number of turnovers at halftime, which I know their coaching staff and their fans have been as well.
What he needs to do is raise the hotel and rental car taxes because the guests here today in Maryland are not treating their hosts very well.
Not at all. There's a lot of people they haven't treated very well.
Oh, wow. That hurts. My goodness. I mean, Gary Williams is doing all he can right now to hold back a smile.
That is just plain explosion.
You need clearance from the tower to take off like that.
Steve Francis had to call Hartsfield Airport before that move. Akins lost it out of bounds. Oh, or was it swatted out of bounds? I'm going to say last touch by Dixon.
I mean, what do you say to this? Substitution number 12. I mean, just get out of the way.
Plus, it's over a seven-footer.
Unbelievable hops. When he turns that left shoulder in toward the basket, you know he is in. He's putting out the landing gear up, and he's ready to take off.
He and Chris Porter over at Auburn get up as good as or as well as I've seen anybody ever, maybe, at their particular sizes. Alvin Jones got mugged underneath the basket.
Well, that dunk that Chris Porter had against LSU where he basically cupped it around his waist on a rebound and then windmilled it right into the basket was absolutely amazing. Cliff Ellis said it was the best dunk he had seen in person in his 31 years as a coach. And Steve Francis coming off a great performance against North Carolina where the Terrapins won for the second time against the Tar Heels this season.
Of course, the difference with Francis and Porter is Porter, depending on who you talk to, is anywhere from 6'5 to 6'7. Steve Francis is 6'3. But my, oh my. What it must be like to fly.
And he's fearless. I remember in their game against Kentucky, he took it to Jamal McGlure to dunk. McGlure blocked it, and the next play, he took it right back at him and got a foul. Yep. I mean, he is absolutely unafraid of anyone.
Alvin Jones, I got to give the big fella credit. Playing on a bad ankle, has 16 points, 10 rebounds, and hasn't 11 rebounds now. And hasn't missed from the free throw line, and he came in under 50% from the stripe and hasn't missed one today.
Might be scoring a few points with the NBA scouts here today to watch this game.
Aiken short on a three. And another rebound by Jones. That one rolled off on the baseline jumper.
Jones will be a good pro someday. He needs to stick around and work on his game. He's not ready yet, but has all the tools.
Stokes gave up a three, trying to leave it in the paint for Martisic, who drew a foul from John Babel. That'll be three on Babel. Triple header coming up on Big Monday, presented by Bud Light at 7:30. We start things off in the Big East. UConn will take on Providence. UConn will lose that number two ranking, but they'll still be somewhere in the top five. Oklahoma State and Kansas next, then out west. TCU and UNLV at midnight. All three games on Big Monday, presented by Bud Light. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of GoNetworkGo.com.
How about Roy?
Williams. Kansas beats Oklahoma yesterday. He gets his 300th victory as a head coach, quicker than anybody in the history of this game at the Division I level. He's only been a head coach for 11 years, and he's already got 300 wins.
That's pretty strong.
That's remarkable.
Kyer goes out. Floyd comes in. Martisic at the free throw line. A 7 foot, 255-pound redshirt sophomore out of Boston.
Getting some more playing time without Ikeezy in the lineup after that ruptured Achilles tendon. And he's responding.
Missed both free throws, though. And a 27-point Maryland lead. Unless Georgia Tech does something almost as dramatic as Maryland did in the last 5 minutes of the first half, it's just a matter of what the final score is going to be in this one. And Maryland will be 23-4 and wrap up the number two seed in the Atlantic Coast Conference tournament. Morris on the baseline, leaves it for Martisic. Nice move with the left hand. Too strong off the glass, though.
He's just not finishing plays. He's this close to being a good player.
D.J. Vines will try three. Got it.
Three for D.J. Vines.
T.J.'s good three-point shooter. That's his 38th that he's dropped in for the little guy out of Woodstock, Georgia.
Well, he spots up very effectively. That's why you've got to make him put it on the floor where he is less effective. He can still do it. He's just not as good as he is.
Morris. Jones blocked the shot, and that puts him in the record book alone. That passes John Sally all time in 2 years.
I mean, he hasn't even played 100 games yet.
And the PA announcer just made the announcement to a nice response from the fans. The Spider-Man's record is no more. Outlet, and nobody gets to that one. So it'll go back to Georgia Tech. That is pretty phenomenal. Alvin Jones has 103 blocks this year and now 244 in two seasons.
Yeah, it is a remarkable achievement, but John Sally will still keep the record. He just won't get the press guide anymore.
That's right.
He'll just keep it home, the old one that shows him number one.
Spider may be watching today, and we can all chuckle about that because we all know him. Sally and Price, part of that renovation of Georgia Tech basketball under Bobby Kremins. His place was not quite on the ACC map when they all showed up. And so that's why, through a tough season, I think people have to remember that Bobby Kremins resurrected this program into a team that has won ACC champions and gone to a Final Four. And sometimes the fans lose sight of that, I think.
Yeah, Bobby Kremins built this program. Without him, Georgia Tech is not on the national map. And you're right, but fans and media people tend to forget that. But this gentleman has done a remarkable job as a head coach. One of the longest tenured coaches, along with Mike Krzyzewski, in this league. Won ACC titles in both the regular season and the tournament.
Today, his team was up by three with 5:23 left in the first half before the Maryland Terrapins showed why they're number five in the country. And last touch, let's see. And Gary Williams gives Juan Dixon an earful.
Boy, Juan Dixon really gave up his body on that play, going after the ball, winding up on the floor.
Like he was playing in an NFL secondary. 69-45, and we're down to 9:18 remaining in the ballgame. Collier wants it down low, and Floyd has it swatted away by Prophet. LaRon Prophet, you said it earlier, Jay. What a great set of hands and anticipates. That's why he's got so many steals. Jason Floyd, I don't think, has had one pass with Prophet on him today that wasn't contested.
And a bunch of them that have been deflected, tipped.
Right. Jones, a little bit off on the turn.
Nice job by Watkins to run the court.
Morris for three. He do a little bit of everything, can't he?
He's just smooth on top of smooth. So quiet, he doesn't run down shaking his fist after he scores. He just plays.
How many guys do you know that can have 23 pointers and have 60 some blocks as well? That's playing all the way around.
Well, he's just an offensive weapon too. He steps to the free throw line, he hits 85%.
Jason Floyd tried a three, it rattled out on him. Kyer tried to hustle for the rebound. Jason, hustle, Jason. Steve Francis checking back in for Maryland, and Dixon goes out.
Francis never had the luxury of playing high school ball. Wound up with his GED instead of a high school diploma. Spent 2 years in junior college at both San Jacinto and Allegheny in Maryland.
Collier missed the outside jumper. Francis was the trailer. Stokes knew he was there.
The guy is a human pogo stick.
22. As he outdoes his birthday by one.
Timeout, Georgia Tech.
And I'll tell you what, every day is Gary Williams' birthday when he thinks about having Steve Francis in his program. Look at that, going to the other side and just rising up as he's turning around.
That is just beautiful to watch.
It's phenomenal. It's absolutely phenomenal. And those are the skills that whenever he does get to the pro level are going to set him apart.
He's a very unselfish player, too. A lot of people don't realize that he's up there in the top 10 in assists. He's sixth in the conference in assists. And he could very easily be the point guard were it not for Terrell Stokes. So he can play the point. He can play the two. He can take the elevator to the top of the tower. We know that.
Well, that just gives Gary Williams that much more versatility with his lineup. He can have two point guards in at the same time with Stokes and Francis. And then Juan Dixon can come off the bench as a shooter. And Francis can move over to the point spot and give Terrell Stokes a little bit of a rest.
8:15 left in the ball game. 29-point Maryland lead.
Every day, 37 lives are claimed by heart disease in Arizona. It's America's number one killer. Kids growing up today may not have statistics like that in their future because of the work of the American Heart Association. You can help by donating a vehicle you no longer want and get a nice tax deduction, too. It's as easy as child's play. It's a simple phone call. Whatever the condition of the vehicle, Yank Your Part will come running for the American Heart Association. Call today.
From the convenience of your home, you know you've always wanted one. And now's the time to call and get your Power Pro with no money down and payments as low as $33 a month. Did you get your workout today? For a free video and brochure, call right now. Bowflex Fitness, the choice for fitness at home.
Alvin Jones backing in. Nice move with the left hand. And a chance to make it a three-point play.
Well, you're right, Brad. Alvin Jones has really gutted it out in this game with that left ankle injury. Here he gets in the low block, just a little drop step to the basket. Uses that great strength, and his offensive game has improved so much over last year. He had all the shot blocking, but did not quite have the offensive game that he brought, and there is the violation that will take it the other way.
That's 20 turnovers against Georgia Tech, and it negates an opportunity for a three-point play as Jason Floyd jumped in the paint.
That's one call I've never really liked. I think you ought to wait to see if the guy makes it or not. You know, if he misses it and you gain an advantage by getting in early, then blow the whistle and give it to the other team. Otherwise, let him shoot it.
Watkins off the glass. He's got four.
Did a nice job of bumping off the defense and then a little step back move for the shot off the window. You don't see that much anymore.
Jones working hard against Watkins. Wants it down low. And Collier instead gets it. Left hand hook. Won't go. Jones trying to battle for the rebound.
And Morris took one right in the eye. Morris really got up there to challenge that jump hook by Collier. You can see Collier with the ball inside using that left hand to go up for the jump hook, and Morris is right with him, putting that pressure on the ball, not able to get the block. Terrence Morris, I think, will be all right after he took that little elbow right in the chops.
He's going to come out.
Maryland substitution number 35.
Took us a while to get John Flaherty's eye cleared up. Now Terrence Morris has the same problem. 7:23 remaining. Floyd looking to get it in. Francis steals it. Just elevated to steal. Leaves it for Stokes. Stokes missed a layup.
I think Stokes was looking to throw it back up for Francis and then had to wind up shooting it in the end.
Floyd has 5 points and Akins has only three. Georgia Tech's backcourt has not been. been a factor at all today. Collier's outside jumper was off the mark. Profit going to work on offense. Nice hook pass around to Watkins, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Well, Laurent Profit is just so unselfish in a game where Maryland has got it well in hand. Sometimes players like to take it upon themselves to get numbers, and not Laurent Profit. He took the ball to the basket and then dished it off to a teammate that before the injury to Akizi did not get a whole lot of playing time, and that's Brian Watkins. So that's an unselfish play by the senior Profit.
Watkins knocks down the free throw.
Georgia Tech substitution.
You look at Laurent Profit and what his numbers are going to end up being, Jay. He's obviously going to go over 1,500 career points. He'll probably end up at 300 assists, over 500 rebounds, and 250 steals. That's playing the game.
And playing it in an all-around sense. And putting up those kind of career numbers. You know, 1,000 points is really the benchmark of an outstanding career, but guys like Profit putting up 1,500, Akizi had over 1,100 and over 800 rebounds. What a shame that he's not going to be able to play in the NCAA tournament.
Good move by Collier, just didn't finish it.
Well, you can see Georgia Tech a little deflated.
Try to lob it to Profit, and Stokes after the pass picks up the foul as well. 6:28 left in this one.
Number 12,
don't forget championship week. Tips off on ESPN and ESPN2 next Saturday. 61 games in 8 days, including 29 conference championships. Extensive coverage of the ACC, the Big East, and the Big Ten tourneys. It all starts noon next Saturday and ends with the men's selection show on March 7th. Collier with a little left-handed hook on the baseline. 14 for him. Championship week should be fun, presented by 7-Up, and we'll all be plastered all over the country.
The best time of the year.
Sure is. Stokes inside and walked with it.
Just too quick. Right there, a flex cut along the baseline. And the nice little snap in. You don't see Terrell Stokes snapping in to the post very often to post up, but he did on that play.
Vines trying to get it into Jones, and Francis knocks it away. Dixon and Miller will come
Maryland
in.
Maryland substitutions, number 5, Juan Dixon, number 15, Danny Miller.
See Jason Floyd there shaking his head. Things have not gone well for Georgia Tech in this ballgame. Primarily in the first half because they just turned it over too much under the pressure that Maryland put on them.
Aikens the push pass to Collier. This left-handed hook's an air ball. Here comes Steve Francis. You better get back. He leaves it on the trail for Baxter, and Baxter's fouled.
Yeah, Steve Francis can just do it all. And he has got to be college basketball's Roy Hobbs. He just came out of nowhere this summer. Played in the Kenner League in Maryland, and everybody was talking about what a great talent and great player he was going to be, but he was legendary from the playgrounds. Nobody really had seen him play, yet his reputation just took off in the media. The nice little leave behind to Lonnie Baxter. Lonnie Baxter played at Hargrave Military Academy with Corleone Young.
Yep.
Also, Anthony Grundy at NC State is a Hargrave graduate as well.
Abel comes out, Francis goes out, and that might be the end of the day for the birthday boy, and what a birthday it was. And sometimes they're just guys that you have a blast watching, and quite frankly, I'll be honest, he's a guy that I just have a blast watching.
He's just got that energy, obviously the ability, but there's just something about him that you gravitate to.
Yep. Baseline. Alvin Jones outside to Aikens. One field goal today for Tony Aikens. One Dixon. A lob too high off the box, but it comes back underneath to Baxter.
Basket by Lonnie Baxter.
It's awfully difficult to get back in transition defense when Alvin Jones is struggling just to get up court. And Maryland can sense it. They are just breaking out every time that ball goes up by Georgia Tech. They figure they're going to get the rebound. They just run.
Jones wheels on the baseline with a left hand. Collier knocks down Norman Fields. And the ball comes free to the Yellow Jackets. T.J. Vines, a little finger roll, and got the roll.
Basket by T.J. Vines.
30-point Maryland lead, 4.5 minutes remaining in the ball game. Maryland will be going to 11-3. Dixon just threw a hand out there trying to ward off Tony Akins, and he brought him right in the eye. And Collier to the foul. ACC tournament just around the corner now, and if things started today, here's how the matchups would look. Obviously, the number one seed is Duke, Clemson, and Florida State, 7-8. Tech and Wake Forest, North Carolina State, and North Carolina. That's if things started right now.
Well, and Duke would like things to start right now if Virginia would stay in that last spot. I think what you wouldn't like to see if you're Duke is to have to play Clemson in that first round. You don't want to have to play anybody, but you know you got to play somebody. And if Clemson is the number nine team, boy, that is an awfully difficult first round matchup. Yep. Clemson, by many accounts, has underachieved this year, but they have the most seniors and the most depth, perhaps, in the conference. Not depth, but the most experience, excuse me.
They'll play you rugged, too. Saw that yesterday. ACC tournament. Don't forget, you'll see it on ESPN and ESPN2 all the way through. Push as Alvin Jones backs in.
I'll tell you what, that ACC tournament is awfully unpredictable. Last season, as we said, it was almost Clemson and Maryland in the championship game instead of what everybody thought, which was number one North Carolina and Duke.
Just under 4 minutes left. Maryland on their way to their 23rd victory of the year.
Introducing Bosch Platinum Plus 4. Four electrodes. Pure platinum. Take your engine to a higher power. New Bosch Platinum Plus 4.
I must say, I'm amazed.
I am a very stylish girl.
The new Volvo S80. My goodness.
A very stylish girl.
No matter where you are these days, it seems people are using 1010-9000. The easy way to find a phone number.
That's because all you do is dial one number, 1010-9000, to get any listing you want.
And it could be any town anywhere in America.
They'll even dial it for you and not charge anything extra for doing it.
So you don't have to hang up and dial it yourself. That's pretty easy, huh?
You said it.
No, I think we said it together.
Well, obviously you needed some help.
Thanks. 1010-9000, directory assistance for everyone in America.
How do you prove you're the king of college hoops? Just log on to ESPN.com and enter the NCAA Tournament Challenge presented by Pizza Hut and Compaq. Fill out your brackets and you can win a trip to the 2000 Men's Final Four. The NCAA Tournament Challenge, now on ESPN.com.
Just when my kid took the pom-pom off her head, that's when the cameras hit. So, I wanted the grandparents to know I do take my wife and daughter someplace sometimes.
Boy, have you overachieved in life.
Yeah, I sure have. Absolutely. Now, Georgia Tech, a Final Four in 90, a Final 4 minutes here today. And 83-51. Maryland with a lopsided 11th ACC win coming up. Alvin Jones, he has worked hard today.
This is,
I think, as gutty a performance as I've seen Alvin Jones have as Deion Glover looks on.
Well, Duke may have made the league its own this year, but Maryland not far behind. Having lost only to Duke and that blip at Wake Forest, this is a very good basketball team that's very capable of making the Final Four, even without Ekeezy, and that's saying something about their talent.
Coming up next, we've got Big Ten women's hoops action. Number 15, Penn State, takes on Ohio State. Nittany Lions played a close one against second-ranked Purdue last week, and they hope to rebound against the Buckeyes today, so that'll be following us. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of Go Network, go.com. A 30-point Maryland lead. We talked about all the minutes that Georgia Tech's starting five puts on the floor. Jason Collier's still out there. Tony Akins is still out there. Alvin Jones' day, I think, finally done. And a productive one and an injury-filled one as well. Cephas picks up the foul, and Collier will go to the free throw line. Collier 14 today for the ACC's leading scorer. Alvin Jones, a 10th double-double today, 20 points to go with, what do you have, 13 rebounds, 14 rebounds?
He's been so consistent over the last couple of weeks. He had 28 points and 17 rebounds in that double overtime thriller against Florida State, and then he followed that up with 18 points and 16 boards at Louisville. And he really battled against the Cardinals in a very tough game for Georgia Tech, lost by 20.
The double overtime win, Collier, the other big man, at 30 and 10. So Georgia Tech's twin towers played very well against Florida State, but that is their last victory they have to show for anything right now, because they have lost to Louisville a week ago, Wake Forest during the weekend. They're getting throttled right now with 2.5 minutes to go at home, where they played very well this year. 9-3 at home this season coming into this one, and they played Duke Tuck last time that they had the top-ranked team in here and had a lead, actually, in the second half of that one.
Yeah, they were up by 10, and they played Duke tougher than any other team in the league has thus far. Played him to a 10-point game. North Carolina played him to a 12-point game. But Bobby Kremen said his team just at the end of that Duke game might not have believed that they could do it after Trajan Langdon hit a couple of huge shots to break out of his shooting slump, that they were just a smidge away from pulling off a major upset. But they played extraordinarily well in that game.
Babel, nice move inside by John. And they go to the free throw line. There's the big guns, and they were loaded today. And it seemed like Francis and Prophet emptied their chambers there in the last 5 minutes of the first half, especially LaRon Prophet got super hot.
John Babel at the line shooting two.
An open court game, and that's where those three can excel. And you're looking at Terrence Morris, who I believe should be first team All-Atlantic Coast Conference, having an extraordinary year leading this team in scoring, rebounding, field goal percentage, and he's tops on the team in free throw percentage as well. And Steve Francis not far behind in all those categories. Another extraordinarily efficient player who is up near the top of the ACC in steals as well as some other categories.
John Babel rips a couple of free throws. Out of the final 2 minutes. Nice turnaround on the baseline.
Laurent Cephas, another player from Delaware, with LaRon Prophet, a couple terrific players from Xavier from the state of Delaware, Gary Lumpkin and Lenny Brown, also Lloyd Price.
Babel has a pass tipped out of bounds by Hahn. A lot of players getting some time now in the last couple minutes that don't normally see a lot of court time.
Well, and that's why coaches will say there's no such thing as garbage time in a game, that you have to treat every minute on the court as important. And this is an important time for the players on the court here to try to make an impression.
Akins with the right hand, only his second field goal of the day. Talked about the importance of this game, I guess, for Maryland, and keeping ahead of steam and going to 23-4 and how well they've done. Wrap up the number 2 seed in the ACC tournament. For Georgia Tech, this just totally abolishes any kind of hopes of an ACC, or rather an NCAA at-large bid, unless they would somehow win the ACC tournament, obviously.
Yeah, right now Wake Forest really the team that has an opportunity to win their way into the NCAA tournament if they can finish 8-8. I am not sure this year, given how many good teams there are out there in other conferences, that 7-9 in the ACC would make it.
Right.
Last year it did with Florida State, but remember Florida State had beaten Arizona when they were number 1 in December, and also UConn in the NIT.
First time in 20 years, if that indeed ends up being the case, that there will only be 3 ACC teams in the tournament. Kincaid in close. Walk on from Milwaukee. Gets in the scorebook. 89-60.
And this all happening without Obina Ikhizi, the senior. And you have to like the way the Maryland Terrapins have responded to the injury.
This game is going to move Maryland up in the national rankings. Will they be 3 or 4? Depends on how far UConn drops down, courtesy of their loss to Miami. But obviously it's going to be Duke and Auburn 1 and 2. And Maryland with this performance, who knows, they might end up going to 3rd. You never know. Kelly on a runner.
And it puts them back, Brad, in territory where they might be able to grab a number one seed. Yeah. That may be a bit of a long shot, but it certainly could happen. And perhaps Michigan State has solidified a number one seed for themselves, absent a total collapse.
Cephas knocks it down from the outside, and Maryland over 90 points now. They came in averaging 86 a game. And the whole story of this game is that they trailed by three with 5:23 to go in the first half. They finished the first half on a 26-4 explosion over Georgia Tech, and quite frankly, they never looked back in the second half. Outside jumper by Kelly, and that's it. 91-60 is the
traditional minute. Call Mexico, and it's just $2.99 for all calls up to 10 minutes, and only 34 cents for each minute after that. With 1010-220, you save all day, every day. Dial 1010-220 for great savings all over the world.
For 20 points, can you name the greatest, grooviest swing in a 70s sports quiz show ever?
Would you like to try a guess?
Don't even ask us that.
Every weeknight from 7 to 8, ESPN Classic has got all the right answers. It's Sports Challenge. See the hippest, most happening athletes as they compete in the ultimate contest of mental conquest. If you've got a need for knowledge, check the facts on Sports Challenge. Every weeknight from 7 to 8, only on ESPN Classic. Are you old school?
This is ESPN Classic.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starting lineups for this afternoon's game. First, for the University of Notre Dame, number 44, forward, 6'6", senior, Essex Fells, New Jersey, Kelly Tripucka. Number 32, forward, 6'9", senior, Mansfield, Louisiana, Orlando Woolridge. Number 53, center, 6'10", sophomore from Farmington, Michigan, Tim Andre. Number 30, guard, 6'6", senior, Silver Spring, Maryland, Tracy Jackson. Number 23, guard, 6'2", sophomore, Kettering, Ohio, John Paxson. And the head coach for the Fighting Irish, Digger Phelps. And now introducing the Terrapins of the University of Maryland. Number 25 at forward, 6'7", senior, Baltimore, Maryland, Ernest Graham. Number 55, forward, 6'6", senior, Brooklyn, New York, Albert King. Number 52 at center, 6'8", junior, Rocky Mount, North Carolina, Buck Williams. Number 15 at guard, 6'4", junior, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Reggie Jackson. Number 10 at guard, 6'1", senior, High Spire, Pennsylvania, Greg Manning. And the head coach for the Terrapins, Lefty Drizzell.
The matchup between the 10th-ranked University of Maryland, the 13th-ranked Notre Dame Fighting Irish. We'll be back with the ball game in just a moment.
Oh, the world is my oyster. In Nepal, I uncovered an ancient temple. Dinner in the Big Apple was magnifique. Or was I watching the Travel Channel?
For heart-stopping adventure, romantic getaways, and insider travel tips, there's only one place to go. Everywhere we do, the new Travel Channel, now from the Discovery Channel.
Break away!
With the new Travel Channel.
Bottle to your car's engine, and you'll see, feel, and hear a difference almost immediately.
Without a doubt, it's definitely running cooler.
And it's running quieter.
This doesn't shake at all. Look at it.
It's definitely running smoother.
Use Motor Up, and you'll get the same amazing results. And because you don't have to change your oil to add Motor Up, you'll save time and money. Before you spend more on costly repairs, call this number now. Put Motor Up to the test and see for yourself. This incredible 30-day free trial offer won't last long, so call now.
I just had a baby, and with all the added expenses, I just couldn't make ends meet. Collectors kept calling. I considered bankruptcy, but then I heard of Garden State's free counseling service.
Garden State is a nonprofit agency that works with your creditors to make an affordable payment plan for all your bills.
Now all my bills are paid on time, and I can plan for my child's future.
Call now for your free consultation. Call 1-800-99-BILLS.
You know all those stories you hear about how good it was and how much fun we had and how young we all used to be, about how much it all mattered and how much we all cared and how no one has ever done it higher or faster or harder or better. All those stories you hear, they're all true.
It's like glue on the corners and it's hung in tight. It's got a rag top and a contour hood. She goes up, 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 and she's rocking. Let's go!
The 1999 Mazda Miata. Set it free and it'll return the favor.
This is ESPN Classic.
Notre Dame, it'll be Tracy Jackson, number 30. He's coming off of a sprained ankle early on in the week, and John Paxson at guard, Kim Andre at center, Will Trapuka and Orlando Woolridge at center. Buck Williams will be the center, Jackson and Manny the two guards, Graham and King the forwards for Maryland. Buck Williams will be jumping against Orlando Woolridge of Notre Dame to start it off. And Maryland controls. King in the left-hand corner. They'll bring it back outside to Jackson.
Charlie, one interesting matchup. They've got Jackson on Graham. Trapuka, who's a forward, is out playing the guard, Manny.
Notre Dame opening with a man-to-man defense. Manning drives 12 feet out front.
And there's that matchup. Very unusual to see Trapuka in front of to play a guard defensively. Token man-to-man up court. Not real pressure.
Trapuka controlling outside, and he's picked up by Albert King.
I don't think that's a good matchup. Albert King can get in foul trouble on Kelly.
Well, he loses it, but it goes out of bounds off of Graham.
Dennis Graham is a great defensive player when he takes on a personal challenge.
When do we know, Billy?
Well, it depends on who they left. You know, when they match him up against a weak player, he kind of goes into a five, but against a good one, he's tough.
Whistle sound.
John Graham.
Maryland foul, number 25, Ernest Graham. His first
personal on Ernest Graham. 53 seconds into the ball game. Woolridge at the line, shooting two. He's a 66% free throw shooter, but he's been a bit cold recently. He was up in the 70s a couple of weeks ago.
You know, Al and Charlie, it's really difficult when you have guys guarding different people on the other end of the floor to make those switches in the transition game, and that should help Maryland if they can get the ball moving up and down the floor.
It's a 2-1 ball game, Maryland leading. Manning outside.
Zone defense.
Manning controlling, right-hand corner to King. The zone to cut down the speed and quickness of Maryland. Manning, left-hand corner.
Right, Charlie. What they're also doing, they're playing man-to-man inside the zone.
Well, that's the ball they're playing man-to-man.
Rebound, Williams, no good. Williams follows again. The left-hander misses, and the foul is called.
Buck Williams is just too fast off the floor for these guys out there. I didn't see Andre and Klein use up their 10 fouls on it. We're going to see Ernest Graham taking a shot against the matchup zone. Buck Williams, it's got to be one of the nation's great rebounders. Goes up, Woolridge is right there with him. He goes back up with the left hand and gets fouled.
Buck Williams hits his first of two. He's hitting 63% from the line. He's the leading scorer and the leading rebounder for Maryland.
Well, he's 6'8", but he plays around 6'11".
He's got a ball.
Here goes the full court pressure by Maryland. Watch Williams. He's a guy that guards the man out of bounds and still gets down the court to be in position defensively.
Almost traveling. And Andre loses it. Richie Jackson across the timeline. King wanted to go up with a jump shot and was cut off. Graham, 12 feet out, he misses underneath. Coming out is John Paxson. Jackson, good from 14 feet out, Tracy Jackson.
Absolutely pure shooter. He's playing at home now. He got out of the gate fast, so he should have a dynamite day.
Notre Dame back to man-to-man on the way down court.
Maryland leading by 1-4-3. Notre Dame now back to a man-to-man. Manning outside, Trebukas on him, King. Free throw line, forces a 15-footer, that's it. Albert King, first two points.
He actually tripped that time over Woolwich, might have been walking and still made the shot.
Well, he's trying real hard. He had a flat game against Louisville. He went 5-for-20, so that helps getting out of the gate.
Paxton, 8 feet out, good for John.
John Paxton might be the most underrated point guard player in the country.
He makes the offense move for the Fighting Irish. Maryland now leads by one.
He's the coach on the floor, and I think he has the most playing time in minutes.
King, 15 feet out, good. 4 points now for Albert King.
King Albert didn't have either shot, Billy.
Nope, they really were not easy shots at all.